Well, hi there. So it turns out that if great white sharks and trout are both fish, then you are too. Why, you might ask? Because trout are more closely related to you than they are to great white sharks. Take a look for yourself. If you're unfamiliar with these diagrams or unclear on how to interpret them, we have a video that explains them right here. So there are many groups of vertebrates that we would generally consider to be fish. Sharks and other cartilaginous fishes would be one. The ray fin fishes would be another. I've never seen someone argue that coelacanths and lungfish are not fish. The jawless fishes, such as hagfish and lampreys, are pretty darn weird. We can include them with the fish if we want to, or we can exclude them. It doesn't really matter. Let's say that they aren't fish. Feel free to call them fish if you want to. If they're not fish, then the last common ancestor of all fish would be here. If they are fish, then that just changes the last common ancestor of all fish to here. A monophyletic group, as we recall, is a common ancestor in all of its descendants. So if our monophyletic group for fish excludes the jawless fishes, then these would all be fish. If it includes the jawless fishes, then these would all be fish. We can include or exclude jawless fishes. But did you notice who is in this group every time? Oh, that's right. You were. That's because you are more closely related to the lungfish, the coelacanths, and the ray fin fishes than any of them are to the cartilaginous fishes. To say that sharks and trout are both fish, but you are not, is like saying that you and your fourth cousin are both part of the same family, but your brother is not. You can say this, but it would be difficult to justify based on relatedness. So how do you feel about being a fish? And what should you do about it? Well, you have a few options. You can use a different word to represent this clade and no longer use fish as a term to represent a monophyletic group. You could throw out the sharks and coelacanths and the lungfishes and just call ray fin fishes fish. Or you can embrace your inner fish. Now, I often hear people say that humans are not only fish, but reptiles as well. And while I'm fine calling humans fish, it's harder to justify calling us reptiles. That isn't to say that you can't, but all living reptiles, the lizards, the snakes, the turtles, the tuataras, the crocodilians, and the birds, all fall into the diapsid reptile clade. Mammals, including humans, are not part of that clade. Humans are part of the synapsid clade. Diapsid and synapsid are terms that refer to the number of holes in the skull behind the eye. Anyway, the diapsids are more closely related to one another than they are to the synapsids. All modern reptiles fall into the diapsid clade, and we do not. That said, many of the extinct synapsids, such as Dimetrodon, who came in like every pack of mixed dinosaurs but was not actually a dinosaur, did have a very reptile-like appearance. Is Dimetrodon a reptile? If the answer is yes, then so are you, because Dimetrodon is more closely related to you than it is to the diapsids. But if you're okay with not considering it to be a reptile, or any of the other synapsids for that matter, then you have a pretty fine reptile clade without you being a part of it. You are basically the hagfish of reptiles. And now you know. If you learned something today, please like this video. If you'd like to learn more in the future, please subscribe and click the little bell. And we hope to see you real soon.